Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Pixie Love. You guys can call me Pixie. And today we're doing some R/Fat Logic. So I just realized I don't think I've done this week. So perfect little way to end of our week on a special Saturday video. We're gonna do some fat logic. Okay. If you live in a smaller body, you experience privilege and you must acknowledge that. Or here's my thing. If someone lives in a smaller body, they didn't have the privilege of gouging themselves with a bunch of food their whole lives and now get to sit and complain how the whole world is against them because they're fat. Hey, dieters, how does it feel? Is it comfy in bed with your fellow science deniers? And you got the dieter, which of course has to be the female, and then she's laying next to an anti-vaxxer, a flat earther, a climate change is a host, evolution is a crock, and dieting is healthy. Dieters are science deniers. Just a fat girl trying to make a living without working for a man. Sorry, I'm not gonna promote her business. Fuck that. All right, and then someone's like, oh damn, the tea is popping. Oh shit, I really like this. Ooh, this is so good. First of all, you don't need a coach to learn how to intuitive eat, okay? You don't. Second of all, the irony in this freaking post is hilarious. People who go on diets are science deniers, not the people who say that losing weight is impossible, even though it's been proven time and time again that losing weight is 100% possible. And I think their argument might be, well, it's not sustainable. It's not sustainable because a lot of time when you get to a certain point of being overweight, especially to the point where you have to lose hundreds of pounds, you have created a very unhealthy habit with eating, and you can't just go on a diet and expect that to change. You have to work on yourself physically and mentally because there's a lot that deals with getting to that point of being over 300 pounds and plus. No one just gets there because they have a healthy, happy relationship with food. No, that happens because you have an unhealthy relationship with food. Most likely you use food as a comfort. Like me, food is my love language and it's not always good for you. So you become over 300 pounds and now you have to lose weight to be at a normal, healthy weight. And people can have the willpower, whatever, to lose all the weight, but then they go back into their same old, you know, tricks that they used to do and they gain the weight back. That's why weight loss isn't sustainable, because you have to work on yourself mentally as well as physically to lose the weight. Us people who like to go on diets to lose weight, we're the science deniers. Do I have another episode of Science with Pixie now? Do we have to talk about how diets work? I think we're going to talk about how diet works. I know I talked about another one I want to do. I forgot what that is. So we're going to talk about diets now, apparently. But, fun. This is, it's the irony for me. How much exercise does it take to burn off the Thanksgiving Day calories? 6 ounces of turkey? 240 calories, apparently. Nope, not an excuse to punish, okay? Mashed potatoes and gravy, 300 calories. Nope, eating is not a punishable offense. A half a cup of stuffing is 190 calories. Nope, these things do not have to have a toxic partnership, okay? Cranberry sauce, which is 150 calories. Nope, you can find joy and purpose in them, excluded from each other, okay? A roll with butter on it, 180 calories. Nope. You can also just take the holiday and chill for a few days. Piece of pumpkin pie, 180 calories. Nope. Live your damn life without apologies. Okay. But like, here's the thing. If you want to have a nice Thanksgiving freaking dinner, and then the next week, push yourself a little harder so you don't gain weight, there's nothing wrong with that. And exercise is not a punishment. It should not be seen as a punishment. Exercise is very good for you and increase your mood. I always hate going to the gym, but I don't hate going to the gym because I don't like being at the gym. I hate going to the gym because I find comfort in being in my computer room playing video games all day. Once I'm at the gym, I go hard, I push myself, and I guess I quite enjoy myself. Like, I like when I'm there. I just don't like the idea of having to leave my house to go there. You know? So if I had a home gym, it would actually probably be pretty good because I can go whenever I want. Plus, me and my boyfriend like to exercise at two completely different times. If I had to choose, I'd like to go first thing in the morning, you know, get my exercise out for the day, have fun with it, and then live the rest of my day. He likes to go close to the end of the day when no one's there. So I'm just like, eh. Like, by then, I just want to relax and not do anything. So if I had a choice, I would go in the morning. But we only have one membership, so I have to go when he goes. So, but, like, exercise is not a punishment. It's not. And there's nothing wrong when seeing how many calories you have to burn when you eat something. And there's also nothing wrong with enjoying your Thanksgiving meal. And, like, if you can plan for Thanksgiving. You can eat less the week before and after and still exercise the same. Or you can push yourself a little harder at the gym. Like, do a little extra, like, 20, 30 minutes at the gym every day for, like, the week before or the week after without even overthinking about what you ate and still probably be okay. Like, there's so much I can say about this. It's just, if you eat and then exercise, it's not a toxic partnership. Like, you just, your buzzwords. You like to throw buzzwords like, oh, it's toxic and blah, 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 blah. Hey, just hopping in here to let you guys know that you should subscribe. I mean, if you've gotten this far in the video, you obviously love my pretty little face. So just letting you guys know, make sure you guys subscribe to me. Join the little club. We're all very nice down in the comments. So just subscribe, okay? And then let's get back to the stuff. Or content warning, fat phobia. Tragic. I was developing a crush on someone, but then they posted a weight loss photo and said that they were obese since childhood. So does that mean you were getting a crush on someone who wasn't fat? Because I thought, like, fat people were it. Fat people were awesome. Like, we should all love and date fat people. Like, that's what I thought we were. But, like, only you, right? Like, only fat women. Like, if this man was fat, would you still develop a crush on him? Or do you need your man to be, you know, nice and fit and skinny, but you're allowed to be fat, but he has to find you attractive? But like, okay, is it just me? Do these women, like, only like smaller guys? Because, like, I'm just saying, like, they're the ones who say that you have to like fat women. You know, if you don't like fat people, then you're fat phobic. If that's not what you're attracted to, then you're fat phobic as hell. But yet, a lot of the times, they like smaller men, which is nothing wrong with that. But it's like, the ones who are saying that aren't in a relationship with bigger men. A little nugget of truth throwing out there for you. Just a little nugget. It's been a while since we've had a post like this. So I thought we'd bring one up so I can just say what I have to say again. Because I think there's a lot of new people here since the last time I've talked about something like this. So let's go off. The basis of fat phobia was to make black women animalistic and to keep white women as the beauty standard. As more slaves and immigrants were arriving in the U.S., I have no desire to center my health around whiteness and racism. Y'all be safe, though. Okay, so this motion is the fact that this, to me, I said it before, I have a whole video about it. This, to me, basically is saying, because I'm just going to say it was probably a white person who posted this, people who think like this is basically saying that all black women are fat. Like, we're all thicker, we're all fatter, so the reason why people don't want to be fat is because of black women. And I've showed my family are not fat. A lot of them are thick, but we're not fat. And just because black women are curvier, we were not fucking fat, especially when we were brought over as slaves. We were not fat as the term that we see now. They weren't 300 pounds, they weren't 250 pounds, they were probably like 180 at the most. They were just fake women, and that's why they're like, oh yeah, we want that slave because she's thick so she can do more stuff. That's what it was. They weren't fat, okay? They were not literally fucking fat, you guys. Like, you make it seem like when my people were brought over as slaves that we were all 300 and 400 freaking pounds, and they didn't want white people to look like us, so that's why being skinny was the healthy thing to do. That's not what it was. We weren't overweight. No, like, that's not what it was about. So stop fucking making it seem like all black women are fat because they're curvy, because they got bottoms, because we got hips, we got thighs. We were not fat. We are not all fucking fat. Please stop with this rhetoric. This is the most racist thing I've seen on the internet. It's so racist when you're trying to be anti-racist, but you're being racist as hell to just assume that all black women are fat, and to also just assume that we're all curvy. There are very slim, I have friends who are black who are just very slim. Those poor souls have no shape, as we would say. Like, they're just straight. Like, they don't even have curves. They don't got hips. They got little booties. They're just straight. And there's nothing wrong with that. But it's just, there's a notion that all black women are, you know, small waist, big hips, and big thighs, and just assuming curvy. That's not always the case. It does tend to happen in our community, in the Latino community. But there's a Latinos and black women who are, you know, very slim. There's Latino and black women who are very curvy. Just like there are white women who are very slim, and there are white women who are very curvy. Like, it's not, we're not all one size. We're not. And it just frustrates me. This blatant racism frustrates me. And a lot of them based it off of this one lady named, I want to say it's like Sarah something. That might even be her name. Why would her name be Sarah? Anyway, she was in my video before, but we did a little deep dive on her. Her tribe, from what I learned, had like kind of like a disorder. I want to say it starts with an L, but they had very big, like, lumpy hips and butts and stuff like that. And it wasn't just her, it was her whole tribe that kind of had like this disorder or something like that. And she would parade around Europe like a freaking animal, which is absolutely disgusting. But that's not where fat phobia came from. That's one story. And like, that's not what all black women look like. We did not all look like that. So, but yes, let's continue. I'm just wanted to throw it out there. It's been a while since I've talked about this, but this shit pisses me off. I can diet for 1,000 years and I'll still never be a thin person. I'll just be a fat person who's suppressing her weight. My fat is not unnaturally attached to my body or an illness. I am not a thin person who is in the wrong size. My fat body is generally part of who I am and what my body was designed to be. No, and that's another thing. Stop making being fat part of your fucking identity. Like, I think that's why a lot of these people don't want to lose weight, because part of who they are is being the fat chick. Like, you're more than just being a fat person. Just like, I am more than a black woman. My identity is not the fact that I'm black. That is part of who I am. It's clearly what you can see about me. But that's not what my fucking identity is. I don't walk around the place saying, I'm that black bitch. Like, no. Because that's not who I am. It's what I am, but it's not who I am. There's a difference between what you are and who you are. You can still be the genuine, let's just assume this is a genuinely nice, sweet, amazing person who everyone loves. You can still be that in a smaller body, because that's who you are. Who you are is not being fat. And you have to learn to separate that from your identity. There is more to your identity than just being fat. Unless you have no personality and your personality is just being a fat person, then you need to learn to get a personality. Personally. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, leave a like and subscribe to me, because you guys get videos Monday through Friday. Today you got a special video because I didn't post on Thanksgiving. Anyway, all my social medias, everything is pixielove5642. I'll see you guys on Monday. Bye bye.